Ludwig Stumpfegger, the 11th of July 1910, c. the 2nd of May 1945, was a German doctor who served in the SS of Nazi Germany during World War II. He was Adolf Hitler's personal surgeon from 1944 to 1945. Stumpfegger was present in the Führer bunker in Berlin in late April 1945. Early life and career. Stumpfegger was born in Munich in Bavaria. He studied medicine from 1930 onwards. Stumpfegger joined the SS on the 2nd of June 1933 and the Nazi Party on the 1st of May 1935. He initially worked as an assistant doctor under Professor Karl Gebhardt in the Hohenlicken Sanatorium, which specialized in sports accidents. As a result of this experience, he was part of the medical team, along with Gebhardt, at the 1936 Summer Olympics in Berlin and the Winter Olympics of the same year in Garmisch-Partenkirchen. In August 1937, Stumpfegger obtained his doctor's degree. World War II. After World War II began in Europe, the Hohenlicken was used by the SS as part of the war effort. Working under the supervision of Gebhardt, Dr. Fritz Fischer and Dr. Hurt Oberheiser, he participated in medical experiments, the subjects of which were women from the concentration camp at Ravensbrück. On the 1st of November 1939, he transferred to the surgical department of the SS hospital in Berlin. He was transferred back to the Hohenlicken as adjutant to Gebhardt in March 1940. On the 20th of April 1943, he was promoted to SS Obersturmbannführer. Upon Himmler's recommendation, he was transferred to Wolfschanze Führer headquarters as the resident doctor on the 9th of October 1944. Berlin 1945 and death in 1945. Stumpfegger started working directly for Hitler in the Führer bunker in Berlin under the direction of Dr. Theodor Morell. Stumpfegger distributed cyanide capsules to the various military adjutants, secretaries, and staff in the bunker. Doubting the efficacy of the cyanide capsules, Hitler ordered SS physician Dr. Werner Haas to test one on his dog Blondie, who died as a result on the 29th of April. As the Red Army advanced towards the bunker complex, some sources report that he helped Magda Goebbels kill her children as they slept in the war bunker, before she and her husband Joseph Goebbels committed suicide on 1 May. On the 30th of April 1945, just before committing suicide, Hitler signed the order to allow a breakout. On the 1st of May, Stumpfegger left Führer bunker in a breakout group that included Martin Bormann, Werner Naumann and Hitler Youth leader Arthur Axmann. They were one of 10 groups attempting to break out of the Soviet encirclement. At the Weidendammer Bridge, a Tiger tank spearheaded the first attempt by the Germans to storm across the bridge, but it was destroyed. Bormann and Stumpfegger were knocked over when the tank was hit. On the third attempt, made around 0100, Stumpfegger and his group from the Reich Chancellery crossed the Spree. Leaving the rest of their group, Bormann, Stumpfegger, and Axmann walked along railroad tracks to Leerder Station, where Axmann decided to go alone in the opposite direction of his two companions. When he encountered a Red Army patrol, Axmann doubled back. He saw two bodies, which he later identified as Bormann and Stumpfegger, on a bridge near the railway switching yard, the moonlight clearly illuminating their faces. He did not have time to check the bodies, so he did not know what killed them. Discovery of remains. In 1963, a retired postal worker named Albert Crum now told police that around the 8th of May 1945, the Soviets had ordered him and his colleagues to bury two bodies found near the railway bridge near Leerder Station. One was dressed in a Wehrmacht uniform and the other was clad only in his underwear. Krumnow's colleague Wagenfuhl found an SS doctor's paybook on the second body identifying him as Dr. Ludwig Stumpfegger. He gave the paybook to his boss, Postal Chief Berndt, who turned it over to the Soviets. They in turn destroyed it. He wrote to Stumpfegger's wife on the 14th of August 1945 and told her that her husband's body was interred with the bodies of several other dead soldiers in the grounds of the Alpendorf in Berlin and W-40, Invalidenstrasse 63. excavations on the 21st of July 1965 at the site specified by Axeman and Krumnow failed to locate the bodies. On the 7th of December 1972, construction workers uncovered human remains near Leder Station in West Berlin just 12 meters, 39 feet from the spot Krumnow had indicated. Upon autopsy, fragments of glass found in the jawbones of both skeletons led to the conclusion that they had committed suicide by biting cyanide capsules to avoid capture. Dental records, reconstructed from memory in 1945 by Dr. Hugo Blaschke, along with forensic examiners determined that the size of the skeleton and shape of the skull were identical to Bormann's. Likewise, the second skeleton was deemed to be Stumpfegger's, since it was of similar height to his last known proportions. Composite photographs, where images of the skulls were overlaid on photographs of the two men's faces, were completely congruent. Facial reconstruction was undertaken in early 1973 on both skulls to confirm the identities of the bodies of Stumpfegger and Bormann. Bormann's identity was further confirmed by DNA testing in 1999. See also list of solved missing persons cases. References. Citations. Bibliography. Beaver, Anthony, 2002. Berlin, The Downfall 1945. London, Viking Penguin Books. ISBN 978-0-670-03041-5.CS1 maint. Refharv, Link, Helm, Sarah, 2015. If This Is a Woman. Inside Ravensbrück. Hitler's Concentration Camp for Women. London, Little, Brown. ISBN 978-0-748-11243-2.CS1 maint. Refharv, Link, Joachim Thaler, Anton, 1999-1995. The Last Days of Hitler. The Legends, The Evidence, The Truth. Trends. Helmut Bogler. London, Brockhampton Press. ISBN 978-1-86019-902-8.CS1 maint. Refharv, Link, Kershaw, Ian, 2008. Hitler, A Biography. New York, W. W. Norton and Company. ISBN 978-0-393-06757-6.CS1 maint. Refharv, Link, Lang, Jacques Van, 1979. The Secretary. Martin Bormann, The Man Who Manipulated Hitler. New York, Random House. ISBN 978-0-394-50321-9.CS1 maint. Refharv, Link, Letizier, Tony, 2010-1999. Race for the Reichstag. The 1945 Battle for Berlin. Pen and Sword. ISBN 978-1-84884-230-4.CS1 maint. Refharv, Link, Miller, Michael, 2006. Leaders of the SS and German Police, Volume 1. San Jose, CA, R. James Bender. ISBN 978-93-297-0037-2.CS1 maint. Refharv, Link, O'Donnell, James P. 2001-1978. The Bunker. New York, DeCapo Press. ISBN 978-0-306-80958-3.CS1 maint. Refharv, Link, Sweeting, C.G. Hitler's Personal Pilot. The Life and Times of Hans Bauer. ISBN 1-57488-288-0.CS1 maint. Refharv, Link, Trevor Roper, Hugh, 1992-1947. The Last Days of Hitler. University of Chicago Press. ISBN 0-226-81224-3.CS1 maint. Refharv, Link, Whiting, Charles, 1996-1973. The Hunt for Martin Bormann. The Truth. London, Pen and Sword. ISBN 0-85052-527-6.cs1 maint. Ref Harv link.